Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Suraj in Cloud. Since past few years, we are hearing this term GitOps, which is Git and the operations, very similar to DevOps, developer and operations. So I'm quite curious with this concept, and I keep reading about these things. And last week, I came across this very interesting and free certification about GitOps, which I'm going to explain what it is, and all the required links for the same I'll put in the description. So you can also go and do the course and learn more about GitOps. So let's dive into it. As Kelsey Hightower tweeted, GitOps is the best thing since configuration as a code. Now, configuration as a code resembles with the configuration tooling such as Ansible and Puppet. Git changed how we collaborate, but declarative configuration is the key to dealing with infrastructure at scale and set the stage for the next generation of management tools. So basically, when you have a declarative configuration in Git, you exactly know what's deployed onto the production. Now, this is not very specific to Kubernetes or anything. These are the setup standard practices which you can apply in any environment, whether it is virtual machine environment, networking environment, any sorts of environment, right? So with this GitOps in mind, there was a set of companies came together and they formed a community called Open GitOps, where it will define a set of open source standards so that it will help communities and the organizations to have a standardized approach of GitOps. Now, it is very similar to how OCI, which is Open Container Initiative, helps with the container runtime, standardizing the container runtime, as well as how we build the container images. Very similar approach. So these, as of now, these seven companies are being part of the Open GitOps community, specifically Amazon, Azure, CodeFresh, Crayon, GitHub, Red Hat, and the Weaveworks. You may have seen many articles around GitOps from CodeFresh and WeWork specifically. So as I said, the certification which I'm talking about, and it is entirely free, is GitOps Mastery, basically GitOps Fundamental, and it is given by the CodeFresh. Now, I'm very, very thankful to the CodeFresh for giving all of us the opportunity to learn about GitOps, and that to be absolutely free of cost. And I just on this weekend, I completed the course, and it was very, very helpful. And this is little exam at the end, and I finished that, and I got the certificate as well. As I said, how much it cost, like I said, free, I know, but when it comes to certification, the first question anyone asks is how much it cost. So trust me, it is 100% free, unlike any other places where, like, you know, the course is free, but you pay for certificate or anything, nothing like that. It is 100% free. But rather than certification, I would say focus on the content, which is really good. Now, for whole content to learn and do things, I think I spent around 3 to 4 hours. It may take more if you are beginner as well, but around 4 to 5 hours time you will need to finish this course. Now, you don't need them in like one go. You can like do 1 hour daily each and finish the course off as well and gain the certificate, which may help you as well. Now, the important bit is what will you learn. Now, one thing is clear, you will learn about GitOps, but what's there in it for you so you can really focus on it. So these are the major content of the course where it talks about what is the GitOps, what's the ideology and philosophy of GitOps. Now, GitOps, as I said, it can be on anything. It's not just container or Kubernetes focused. It can be anything. So the first pillar, GitOps, will explain and go through that. Now, specifically, this course focuses on Argo project ecosystem, the tooling which are there in Argo. It uses as a reference to explain the concept of GitOps. Now, the second thing is Argo CD, which is one of the tool from Argo ecosystem. So it uses Argo CD to explain us the various concepts of GitOps. The third bit is progressive delivery, as in how you can deliver the application with a higher confidence. And the example which is taken here is Argo rollout. So the course content has some scenarios around it with which you can understand the concepts of DevOps. And then there is a little exam as well. If you go more in detail, like what exactly it looks like, so few things around how secret management works in terms of GitOps, because when we talk about GitOps, that means literally everything is in code, what is being deployed on the production, the same configuration is in a Git history. But what about secret, right? How you can do that? It's not safe to store the secret, but how you can do that, because there are some ways to do it. One of the way I have covered in my other video in the same GitOps playlist with the help of Seal Secret Controller. You can check that out. Various rollout strategies, like for example, some organization benefit from doing blue-green deployments. Some organization benefit from canary deployment. So what are those different rollout strategies? How do they work? And along with the examples, and also health of the application, how you can check the health of the application. And since this course takes example of Argo ecosystem, which revolves around Kubernetes, it also talks about customize and helm, how you can manage the configuration more better with the help of these toolings. As I mentioned, this uses Argo CD and Argo rollouts project from the Argo ecosystem to demonstrate these things. And the exam, once you cover the course, the exam is pretty easy, straightforward. It just comprises of 23 multiple choice question. But I would say do not focus on exam, learn the content thoroughly because it will help you to understand the philosophy of GitOps, how does it work, which is really, really good. And when I logged into the console, which was given by CodeFresh, for the link I'll post in the description as well, there were few courses which is coming soon. I'm really excited for these courses as well. So they are GitOps at Edge for edge computing devices and stuff, and the GitOps at scale, like at higher scale, how you can do it. So I'm really excited for these courses, and soon they will be coming and I'll cover them as well. And again, I'm really thankful for these courses. So thank you so much, CodeFresh, for these courses. I really learned a lot from this. So this was my quick overview on this GitOps fundamental certification by CodeFresh. Again, I'm repeating this again. I personally learned a lot, and this was totally free. So I would say feel free to check this course out and learn more about GitOps. If you have any questions, you can ask in comment section as well. If you have any feedback, let me know. But again, thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Thank you.